Hi there, my name is Walik Burry and I'm a Principal Solutions Architect working at AWS. In this demo, I'm going to show you how you can configure and use an Amazon FSx for Lustre file system as a persistent volume within an Amazon EKS cluster using the CSI driver. I'm also going to show you the benefits of using FSx for Lustre's native Amazon S3 integration, which allows you to set up automatic import and export of data between the FSx for Lustre file system and an S3 bucket that it is linked to. This allows for the FSx for Lustre file system to act as a high-performance cache for hot data stored in an S3 bucket. For high-performance use cases, such as machine learning and training, where you could have hundreds or even thousands of pods that need access to the same training data, wouldn't it be awesome if you could attach the same persistent volume, such as an FSx for Lustre file system, to all your pods and have a shared high-performance volume that stores your training data or hot assets? I will start the demo by showing how to install the CSI driver for FSx for Lustre on an EKS cluster. For this demo, we already have an FSx for Lustre file system pre-provisioned for us, so I will use the Kubernetes static provisioning method to simply create a persistent volume definition to the existing FSx for Lustre file system so that we can use it within an EKS cluster as a resource. Now, I want to point out that you can create a standalone FSx for Lustre file system or an FSx for Lustre file system that is linked to an S3 bucket to allow for automatic data import and export. In this demo, we are using an S3 linked FSx for Lustre file system. Once the persistent volume definition is created, I'm going to create a persistent volume claim to the persistent volume so that pods can use the PVC as a volume. I will deploy a pod on the EKS cluster, which uses the persistent volume claim. And lastly, I will log into the EKS pod, where I will show you what the mounted PVC looks like, then create data on the mounted persistent volume claim to show you the automatic data import and export capability to an S3 bucket. Okay, let's start the demo. Let's install the CSI driver for the FSx for Lustre service on an EKS cluster that has two compute nodes. First, we need to create an IAM policy that will allow permissions to operate with the FSx for Lustre service. Let's create an EKS cluster service account that uses that IAM policy we just created. Now we're ready to install the CSI driver, where it will install the package from the GitHub repository. As you can see, the CSI driver will deploy two sets of pods on each EKS cluster node. We are now going to create a persistent volume using a YAML file definition. In order to do this, we need to get the details of the FSx for Lustre instance that our admin has already provisioned for us. So we will go to the Amazon FSx console and get these details. Let's look at the instance details. We can see that this is a 1.2 terabyte FSx instance. We are going to copy the values that are highlighted, such as instance ID, storage capacity, mount name, and the DNS name, and use them to create our persistent volume definition file. I have created a persistent volume definition already, where I have given the PV a name of FSx-PV, and also copied across the FSx instance values we noted earlier. Let's go ahead and create this PV definition. We can see that the PV has been bound. Now let's create a persistent volume claim definition to the FSx-PV we just created, so that we can use the FSx for Lustre persistent volume as a storage volume within an EKS pod. In my persistent volume claim definition, I have specified a name for the PVC, the name of the PV that I want this PVC to be bound to. Let's go ahead and apply this persistent volume claim definition. The PVC has been created successfully and is bound to the PV. We are now ready to deploy a pod that uses this PVC. In your pod deployment file, you need to specify the name of the PVC to attach and also the local mount path. In this case, we are mounting the persistent volume claim under /work-dir. Okay, let's deploy the pod. Let's log into the pod. We can see a 1.2 terabyte FSx for Lustre file system has been mounted under the /work-dir as per our pod deployment definition. Given we have deployed an FSx for Lustre file system that is linked to an S3 bucket, when we perform a list operation on the folder, we are actually seeing what's stored in the S3 bucket through the FSx for Lustre file system. Now, how cool is that? Being able to integrate with the data in your S3 bucket without any code. Note that the data will only be pulled into the FSx for Lustre file system from the S3 bucket upon first access, where subsequent access to the same data will be served directly from the FSx file system at sub-millisecond latencies. Also, newly written data to the FSx file system can be automatically exported to the S3 bucket based on your configuration. This means that you could have a small 1.2 terabyte FSx instance deployed to act as a high-performance cache to hundreds of terabytes of data stored in Amazon S3 bucket. Now let's test the automatic data export feature of FSx file systems linked to an S3 bucket by creating a new file and verifying it's exported to the linked S3 bucket. You can see which S3 bucket is linked to your FSx instance by navigating to the Amazon FSx console, selecting your instance, and looking at the data repository tab. Now this is the S3 bucket linked to our FSx instance. Let's go check out if the new folder that we created called new data and the file test.txt were exported to this S3 bucket. We can see that both the new folder and the file have been exported to the S3 bucket. Okay, let's recap on what you observed in this demo. We showed you how easy it is to configure and use an Amazon FSx for Lustre file system as a persistent volume within your EKS cluster and its deployed pods, where you can deploy an FSx for Lustre file system either as a standalone instance or as an S3 linked instance. We also demonstrated how automatic data import and export works for S3 linked FSx for Lustre file systems, which is really beneficial for pods that require both high performance storage and S3 data integration.